Today, I want to talk about job hunting, which for most of us brings up some pretty difficult feelings, especially if you're trying to break into a really competitive industry like data analytics. We've got things like the Instagram effect, where you see people posting that they finally got a job and it makes you feel like you're left behind. And then also the opposite of that, which is the doom and gloom of seeing posts on LinkedIn of people saying how many resumes they sent in, how many interviews they haven't gotten, and how many months it's been. And without a clear reference point, it can be very easy to feel very lost in this entire landscape. The thing is, job hunting, it is difficult, but it is not impossible. If you have the right approach, it will be a matter of when and not if. If you are new here, I'm Christine. I am a former data hiring manager and also a data mentor who has helped almost 100 students along in their data journeys. And in this channel, we talk about the strategies and the frameworks that will accelerate your path to becoming a data analyst. In today's video, I want to talk about the practical tips and strategies that can make your job search healthier and less stressful, because ultimately that is how you're going to succeed. Let's dive in. So the first step is to set the right expectations. As data people, let's talk numbers. On average, students in my program, and this is just a calculation of the cohorts over the last year, send an average of 80 to 100 resumes out. So they do 80 to 100 job applications. They interview with 5 to 7 different companies, and that ultimately trickles down to 1 to 2 offers. Now, of course, this is just an average, so it's not gonna represent everyone's job search process, but I find that to be a really helpful benchmark for you to know, okay, what does a decently good job search look like? Now, this ends up trickling down to a resume to interview conversion rate of about 7 to 10%. I have seen some people go as high as 80 to 90%, which I know sounds kind of insane, but this is for people who are very targeted in their job search. They spend a lot of time on their resume and portfolio, really making it stand out, and they also use a strong networking strategy. If you are at 200 applications with 0 interviews, even if you're at 50 applications with 0 interviews, it means that something needs to change. It doesn't mean it's you. It doesn't mean there's something wrong with you. It just means that something needs to change in your targeted strategy or your resume, and that is 100% fixable. Now, the second part is to understand the priority at each stage. You can think of the job hunt process as a funnel. So in the beginning, we have this resume and cover letter side of things where you're gonna focus a few months on making this resume and your portfolio really strong and hopefully getting some experience with real world data and real stakeholders. Then when you move on to the HR phone screen, this is where you wanna start prepping for the behavioral part. If you sign up for my newsletter below, it will send you a list of the questions that covers like literally 80% of the kinds of behavioral questions and kinds of business case questions that I have seen students bump into in their interviews. And this list has grown over time as students have also contributed to it. So at that stage, you're really just focusing on the kind of about you behavioral questions and maybe some light technical prep. Then as you move into the middle stage, that's where you might get a take-home test. So that's where you wanna make sure to brush up on your Excel and SQL and dashboarding skills. And then when you move on to the more rigorous behavioral interviews, like the hiring manager interview, that's where you really want to focus on the more situational questions, like the questions that you would answer with the STAR framework. So for example, tell me about a project you worked on where you delivered insights and metrics and who were the final stakeholders and impact. Then when you move on to the panel in the last stage, that's where you're going to focus more on questions that are a mix of the kind of business case questions that you might get asked and also thinking about some of the more strategic questions you might get asked that are more around culture fit, your overall high level goals, and how you handle different situations at work. So you can see that at each stage, you are not trying to focus on everything. If you can really just break down what needs to happen at each stage, it makes everything a lot less overwhelming and more focused. It's always better to have a bit more high quality deep work and focus than to end up feeling super scattered because you're trying to do everything all at once. Now, the third part is that mindset is part of the equation, and I genuinely mean this. I see all the time that students go through lots of ups and downs when it comes to the job search process, because in those cycles of searching, sometimes you'll hear back a lot, sometimes you won't hear anything, and so it really is like a roller coaster ride. But you need to keep going because it is not rejection, it is redirection. And the reason why I can confidently say that is because I see students go through processes where they almost get a job and then it ends up not being that job, but then ultimately the one that they land, which was a learning process from all the interviews that came before that ends up being way better than all the other opportunities that came before them. So here is a message from a student, Mike. He said, "Thank you everyone from cohort 2. I'm still in disbelief after a 6-month grind and really a year in the making of applications, networking, and being passed on at various stages of interviewing. I got my dream position, company, and industry, and I feel so grateful, honestly. And I saw him go through many ups and downs, and in the end, his resilience and his ability to learn from every single interview is what ended up landing him that dream job. My second mindset tip is to remove yourself a little bit from the emotions by grounding yourself in numbers. So use a job hunt tracker where you can actually see the applications that you've sent out, who you're hearing back from, so that you can continue to iterate your process if you see that something isn't working after a month or two. And then my last note here on the mindset is to prioritize your energy and your mental health. This genuinely is one of the biggest ingredients in their interview process because you need that energy and you need that enthusiasm in the actual interview. This is the difference between showing up to an interview and feeling really timid, feeling like you really, really need this job and not really being able to be yourself, as opposed to being able to approach the interview with curiosity and actually making a connection with the other person. So I recommend time boxing yourself. Only give yourself a certain number of hours each week to apply to jobs. Do not look at every single alert that LinkedIn sends you when a new job has been posted. You know, just give yourself that time period to actually scoop all the new jobs that have been posted. And then once that is done, detach from your computer. Leave the computer, go on a walk, make a nice meal for yourself, make some plans with friends, exercise a little bit, because the more you can stay sane and more relaxed throughout this process, easier said than done, I know, but the more confident you will be when you step into the actual interview. And then my last bonus tip is to find ways to make your job search community driven. Having a community, which can even be just one or two other people who are on the same journey as you, can help a lot. So you can start this by posting on LinkedIn, sharing a bit about your progress, the projects you're working on, proposing if anyone ever wants to hop on a call and collaborate or co-work on a project together. Go out there, try to find some accountability partners or people who are willing to work on projects with you. You will be surprised by how much further your learning and your confidence goes when you have that environment. If you are feeling overwhelmed, here's what I want you to remember. Job searching is a marathon, not a sprint. So ground yourself in realistic expectations and balance resilience with patience. I really believe, and I have seen firsthand, that for every person who has that level of resilience, creative thinking, and follows this roadmap, it is a matter of when, not if, and you can 100% do it too. That's it for today's video, and I will see you in the next one.